The brogan was the enlisted man's footwear during the War of 1812. The shoe was made of thick, sturdy leather, rough side out. This would change to smooth side out later in the 19th century. It is ankle high, and they were actually made on a straight last. This means there was no left or right shoe. This helped immensely in turning out production of the shoes. The leather processing was so good at the time that the individual shoes would actually form to the wearer's foot within a day of wear. The cheaper leather, commonly used for slave shoes, would still only take 2 to 3 days to form to the foot, therefore creating the left and right shoe. The reconstructed brogans that reenactors use today are not quite as supple, but that's because the leather processing of the 18th and 19th centuries used lots of nasty chemicals that we know today are extremely hazardous to both the cobblers and the environment. The sole of the shoe would be stitched or pegged onto the uppers, and a metal plate would be attached to the heel. When the most common form of travel is on foot, the shoes needed to last as long as possible. This reproduction brogan is a couple of years old, and you can already see the wear on the heel plate. Brogans were also known as Jefferson boots, or Jefferson shoes. The name comes from U.S. President Thomas Jefferson. At his first inaugural address in 1801, Thomas Jefferson wore a black suit, silk stockings, and shoes with laces. This was a big deal in the world of fashion. The most common type of men's footwear up until then was the buckled shoe. Thomas Jefferson was quite the Francophile and a big supporter of the French Revolution, which had just ended 2 years earlier in 1799. Buckled shoes had become a symbol of the aristocracy, who were pretty unpopular in France at the time. By abandoning the favored buckled shoes for laces, Thomas Jefferson was making a statement for freedom and independence at his presidential inauguration, and the public noticed very quickly. Laced-up shoes were in, buckles were out.